previously on crisis center.
Yes, we have a suicide caller on the
John,
line at San Francisco Assistance Center.
John, don't. No, don't. No, he won't. Please talk to me. Keep talking.
She's seeing a therapist, and I'll be watching. When she falls, I catch her. Human safety net, okay?
Now, I'm not saying that any of this is your fault. But having someone suicide on you is a life-changing experience, one that some people never get over.
Is it the opinion of the center that Ms. Goodman was fully prepared to handle a life-and-death situation on her own?
She complied with every rule.
Look, if after reading through all of these cases, you still feel that we have made an error in judgment, then go ahead. Shut us down. Because she is exactly the kind of person that we are about.
I found them at the organic food store. Pitless. It's much better than having cookies and candy around, don't you think?
Now, don't forget to take 2 copies of your birth certificate when you go downtown, okay? Okay, who's next?
I am. I've been waiting longer.
Fine.
You know, you ought to have numbers.
Nando, what did you name the Pappas file when you entered in it? It won't come up on the screen.
Well, that's because I haven't done it yet.
I gave it to you on Monday.
You want a typist? Hire a dump.
So I see you got a job, Mr. Colby. How's that going?
Work in a parking lot. Used to be a stockbroker. How do you think it's going?
Did you have any psychological counseling while you were in prison? And I don't see any record of it.
Look, I don't need a shrink.
It's a condition of your parole.
I made a mistake. I know that. I did my time, okay? I just want my life back. I want some privacy. And I want Greg Baker to leave me the hell alone.
Jenny, how did you find us?
You helped Cecilia's cousin. She's our housekeeper.
Okay. So your parents don't know that you're here?
My dad's working. She doesn't know what I do during the day.
And how about your mom?
I want you to help her. Daddy says she drinks too much. She goes crazy sometimes. It's really loud.
He calls me in the middle of the night and asks me how I can sleep after what I did. It was an accident. I don't even remember getting in the car that night. I spent 3 weeks in the hospital myself. I just want for this to end. He said we're gonna let it go. I got this in the mail today. I mean, does he think I wanted his wife to die? When is he gonna stop blaming me? I just want this to stop.
Hey, we're trying to work out here.
Sorry. So, Jenny, I need to ask you a few questions. What is your last name?
Maxfield.
And your mom's name?
Len.
And how about your dad?
Jason.
Is he the man who owns the newspaper?
Nando! Aren't you supposed to be on garbage detail this week?
Yeah, I'll get to it.
says organic pitless cherries.
Hey, I know what a pit feels like, lady, okay? Here.
Just hang in there, everybody. We'll get to you as soon
as
we can.
Greg, I need to talk to you. A little girl came to me and said that there are problems at home, and I think it might turn out to be a pretty high-profile case.
Had this blouse since law school.
Oh, and that's my fault, too?
You could have aimed him the other way.
Problem?
This girl's been on my ass all morning.
Maybe it's Kathy.
Hey,
what is with everybody today?
How about her name?
No idea. I've seen her in and out of the neighborhood for the last few months, but she lived on the streets.
And she never came to you for anything?
No, she wouldn't even talk to us. A couple of the volunteers tried, but she just wanted us to leave her alone.
Well, she's a Jane Doe now.
Well, what happens to her?
They'll do an autopsy. Probably won't bother you again.
Even if he is a volunteer, he has to do his part around here.
I'm a caseworker, not a janitor.
Look, if you're telling me
Rick,
we need help,
I really need
I
to
get
talk
the mess.
To you. Can you please talk to
Rick? I've got Ron Colby's parole officer in line, too.
Oh,
Rick,
finally.
Just give me 2 minutes.
Gotta take this one.
I thought we weren't together around here.
Did you know the smallest fish in the world is a tiny goby? They have them at the aquarium. You want to go?
I'm going to talk to your mom for a little while, but then I have to get back to work, okay?
She's gonna get mad at me because I told you all this stuff.
You missed your piano lesson.
Is Mrs. Maxfield home?
Yes.
There's been a lot of trouble at school. It's acting out and making up stories. There you go, sweetheart. Good boy. Oh, she's not even a teenager yet. Oh, God help us.
So there haven't been any problems here at home?
Well, let's see. Oh, she wanted to pierce her navel, but her father and I would not let her. And every morning we argue about her going to the mall after school. We just don't think that it's an appropriate behavior. Oh, Nikki, Cecilia. Come here, sweetheart. Oh, you're all wet.
I'm not all wet.
Yes, you are. All down the front of you. It's very hot. Jenny is a wonderful kid. She's just over imaginative. And, you know, I think with Jason working so hard, I just don't think it's... Oh, Cecilia, thanks. Could you change him for me?
What are you doing?
Thanks. I don't know how people do it without help.
Jenny mentioned something about drinking.
Well, Jason and I are very social. Part of his business. Listen, I'm really sorry that Jenny took up so much of your time today.
You might want to see a family therapist, especially if her behavior's been changing a lot lately.
She needs more activities. It's her spring break, and I should have signed her up for tennis camp, but I just didn't get my act together. You know how it is. Listen, I really appreciate your concern, but she'll be fine.
Was she mad?
Just worried. How about you?
She said I was lying, didn't she?
Jenny, I know that sometimes it's hard when you feel like no one's paying attention to you.
I'm not lying.
Jenny.
Mr. Slayer.
Slayer. Just Slayer, like Sting.
Okay, Slayer. You want to file a lawsuit against Barton's tattooing and piercing parlor?
A big one.
Why don't you show me the mistake? Right. That's not how you spell Virginia.
Glad you gave up that downtown job for this.
Mama, excuse me. What's wrong?
I can't do it anymore, Tess. Michael started a fire in his bedroom.
Was he hurt?
No, but we have to make a change.
Mama, I can't talk to you about this right now.
He's almost 6 feet tall. And when he goes crazy now, I can't control him anymore. You said you were going to look into those places.
Mama, he's autistic. He's not a criminal.
Don't you think I love that boy as much as anybody could? Don't you think I cry my eyes out every night trying to figure out what to do?
I'll come by tonight. Okay?
Yeah.
Mushu blintzes and a turkey on egg bread with mayo. You're such a goy.
Well, thanks for delivering, because I'm completely swamped.
Can I just have a minute?
Yeah, sure.
I've got to talk to you about Norma.
Who?
The woman they found in the alley.
You knew her?
Yeah, she used to come by the deli. Mom would always feed her. I heard that they're going to do an autopsy.
Well, yeah.
You've got to stop them.
Well, Jake, they've got to find out how she died.
She was Jewish. Ma spotted the numbers on her arm. Her whole family was killed in Poland during the war, and she grew up alone. She's got no one to take care of her.
She's a little beyond that now, don't you think?
It's against Jewish law to desecrate the body.
I'll see what I can do.
You Colby's shrink?
Yeah, thanks for seeing me. Can I come in? Your wife?
Yeah.
How long's it been now?
5 years ago next month.
She is gone, Mr. Baker.
And he's alive. You call that fair?
No, I don't. But it's what you're left with. And you've got to start dealing with that.
I am.
By threatening him.
I'm just doing what the law should have done.
An eye for an eye.
A drunk for my wife.
Are you seeing a therapist now, Mr. Baker?
Tina, always wanted a camel hair coat. So I saved enough and I bought her one for her birthday. When I went to identify her body, she still had it on. Only her ribs were coming through it like this. That's how bad he hurt her. And now he's free. So don't give me a lecture about his rights. Tina and I don't have him anymore.
So I guess money isn't everything.
I'd like a shot at disproving that.
The mother seemed okay, but I'm sure the nanny spends more time with the kids than the parents do.
Fortunately, ignoring your children is not a crime. It happens all the time.
You know, my dad was a single parent, and he worked all the time, but he always managed to be there for me when I needed him.
You were lucky.
I thought I was normal.
Normal is both parents working just to make ends meet. Normal is infants in daycare. Normal is a family sitting down to a meal about once a week, usually in front of the TV. Normal is not some Pollyanna experience you might have had or some rich girl complaining that she doesn't have enough.
Thank you for the lecture.
And right now, we've got a full house, and you've been gone for most of the afternoon, so let's try and actually accomplish something today, okay?
What was that about?
Everyone is on edge today.
Full moon.
Oh, please.
No, hey, it's true. People act a little weird. We always get crazier bad guys. Found a guy this morning smashing fire plugs because he thought the city was already under too much pressure.
How much longer do I have to wait here, huh?
Oh, I'm sorry. Just have a seat, and I will be right with you, I promise.
Thought we were having coffee.
Not a good time. Tonight?
Late shift. Tomorrow night? Dinner?
I've done 2 intakes since you went to go get drinks.
Full moon.
Kathy, it's a Jenny Maxfield on the phone, says it's urgent.
Jenny? Okay, she is. Calm down. Yes, I'll be right there. Okay.
What are you doing here?
Yeah. Jenny called me because she was scared.
It's better just to leave her.
Where is Jenny?
She's fine. Just go.
Thank you.
told you I wasn't lying.
I know. I know.
You wanted to see me?
You left us pretty short-handed yesterday.
I know. It was Jenny. She wasn't lying. Her mother does drink. She doesn't even want to go back in the house anymore.
You can't keep going over there. You're not a child and family services worker.
But she keeps calling me.
Is the mother endangering the children?
Yes. She was throwing things and her baby was crawling through broken glass.
All right. We need to file a report with the DCFSS.
Oh, come on. You know it's going to be months before they send anyone out there.
I know, but there's nothing I can do about that. Now, it's not your job to keep making these house calls. We really need you here. We barely have enough hands as it is.
So I should just tell Jenny that her problems aren't important enough? I can't do that.
Think about this, Kathy. What can you do? What can you do? You're going to just announce to the world that Mrs. Jason Maxfield is an alcoholic? Probably not news. Wait a minute, look. I know you really want to help Jenny. But we really have no options here. Now, we can start the ball rolling by filing that report. But until this family is willing to confront its own problems, we've got to spend our time with the people who can.
I thought yesterday was everybody's bad day.
They just keep coming. What do you need?
Well, I've got good news and bad news from the coroner. Which one first?
Good.
Norma's death was ruled an accident. The blow to her head came from the lid of the dumpster she was rummaging through. So no autopsy.
What's the bad?
We can't claim the body. It has to be a family member.
So where does she go now?
Cremation or cadaver.
Cadaver?
Med students have to learn on somebody.
Is that all you needed from me,
Ben? Yeah, that's all I
need. What are you doing here, Mama?
Get here, Mama.
He's echoing today.
Get going.
Helen's sick again, and I can't miss work another day. So, it's all yours.
Hey, girl, it's okay. Mike, man. Okay.
Cecilia tells me that you've been spending a lot of time around here lately. Is Jenny having some kind of problem at school?
No, I work at the San Francisco Assistance Center. Jenny came to us yesterday because she was afraid.
Afraid of what?
Did you see your wife last night?
No, she was asleep when I got home.
She was drinking. Jenny got scared, and she called me to come over.
I know. I smelled it on her breath when I got into bed last night. I've asked her to get help so many times.
Is she an alcoholic?
Well, we are social drinkers. I don't know how it got to be such a problem with her, with us. I know I shouldn't have ignored it, but I just didn't want to admit that something like that could happen to my wife.
It can happen to anybody.
I know I'm very demanding of the people that work with me, sometimes too much. I know I failed, Lynn.
Mr. Maxfield, your wife needs to be in a program.
Well, I can't tell you how many times I've thought about having her admitted. I was just too damn concerned about what it would look like.
I could give you some names.
Morton Lansing? Isn't that the best one for around here?
Yes, that's a good one.
Okay, then I'll rearrange my schedule and we'll check her in tonight. Nothing is more important to me than my wife and children. I just wish Jenny had come to me.
Very pretty colors.
Very pretty colors.
This is an antibiotic. I want you to rub it on you for the next 7 days and then come back and see me, okay?
Come back and see me, okay?
So, who's the next victim?
I have a sexually transmitted disease.
How'd you hear that?
Just wait a minute.
Forget it. Michael. Get it. Come on, Michael. Come on. Forget it.
It's okay.
Get it. It's okay. No, Michael, that's my pen. Come on, give that back.
It's all right, Michael.
Michael.
Give him the pen. Okay, 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 Mike. Okay, okay. Just gonna go over in here, set you up in here.
Everything okay?
It's fine.
No, everything is not okay.
Bob called from FEMA about Mrs. Moskowitz, and Ron Colby is waiting for you in your office.
Great.
And Rick, I know there is a lot going on, but those stairs haven't been cleaned off in 8 months, and they're a fire hazard. And Lily could really use my help with
the
books.
What are you trying to say?
Get a receptionist.
I thought our next session was tomorrow.
You said you knew a cop.
What happened?
He slashed the seats in my car and he keyed the paint. I just don't have that kind of money right now.
You're sure it was him?
He sent me another one. It's like he's stalking me or something. I just want for this to stop, okay? You think your friend will help me?
All right. I'll call him. But I want to try something first.
I'm sorry, I just don't have much of an appetite.
Ah, hey. Cup of coffee is much cheaper than Chez Pierre. But take it from me, don't start bringing your work home with you. It'll never let you go.
Jenny is so young and she's been through so much. I just keep thinking about her tonight.
Kids get through stuff, believe me.
You know, I was 4 years old, but I still remember the day my mom left. Somebody was making bacon. I remember the shirt she was wearing. I don't remember her face, but I can remember that shirt. It was yellow. I hope she's okay.
Still pretty early. Always makes me feel better to do a follow-up if I'm worried about somebody. And it took a lot of begging, but I got our reservation changed for tomorrow night. Want to try again?
Yeah.
Okay. Tess.
Yeah?
I found a shelter where Norma stayed a couple of times. It's the one down in the Mission District that Frank Fawney runs. He might actually know her last name.
Great.
Michael get home okay?
My Aunt Helen came by and got him a while ago. I'm just trying to catch up on everything I should have done today.
Has he always been this hard to handle?
He's a good kid.
Of course he is.
Extremely high functioning. The doctor said he's perfectly capable of living at home.
When he was a child.
We will be fine.
Please don't come here anymore. I am not answering your questions.
I just wanted to know if Jenny was okay after her mother left.
Hey, Mom didn't leave. She's still upstairs. Daddy came home, but he didn't take Mom anywhere.
I'd like to talk to him. Where is he?
He went back to work. She's in there. Sometimes I don't see her for days. Would you just go in to see if she's okay? Please?
Yeah. Mrs. Maxfield?
Cecilia? Is that you? Cecilia, if you...
Oh, my God. What happened to your face, Mrs. Maxfield?
Don't tell him you came here again.
Your husband did this to you?
Please. Don't tell Jenny.
Didn't we have this conversation yesterday?
You told me to get them to help themselves.
Jason Maxfield called me himself, complaining that you'd been harassing his family.
Jason Maxfield beats his wife.
But she has to be the one to press charges. Now, all you've done is exacerbate an already volatile situation. I told you to file a report, not go back to the house.
If I hadn't gone back there, I wouldn't have found out about the abuse.
Look, Kathy, nobody wants anyone to get hurt here. That's why there are rules we have to follow.
You look at Lynn Maxfield's face and you tell me if you remember the rules.
Okay, okay, okay. Time out, time out. Jumping down each other's throats is not getting us anywhere. Now, I know domestics are some of the toughest cases we have, but come on, we're on the same team. Now, Marilyn has brought it to my attention that we could use a receptionist around here. Of course, we have no money in the budget. I have found us a volunteer. Her name is Emily. She's from the Noe Valley Walk-In Clinic. She does have a slight social phobia, but her doctor thinks that this could be great exposure therapy for her. I think she'll do just fine.
I need to see Nando.
He's...
He's...
busy. So, I'll wait.
Maxfield? No, she's not. No, don't worry. I'm sure she's fine. Did you call the police? No. No, they don't have to be involved. Do you know where she could have gone?
I don't want to live there anymore.
You know, when I was a little girl, my parents used to fight all the time. I remember I would hide in a closet so I didn't have to hear the noise.
Did they ever stop?
Some people can never stop. They don't belong together. My mom left. And it was really hard for me and my brother. And I still miss her a lot. But I know now that we couldn't have gone on that way.
I don't want my mom to leave. But if she listened to my dad, then they wouldn't fight anymore.
I don't think that'll solve everything.
Oh, great. Glad you could make it.
Colby, show up.
Right in here.
All right. So I wanted to try it like this before things get too out of hand.
Will you tell him to stop staring at me?
Greg, have a seat, okay? Okay, Ron. You had something you wanted to say.
I don't know how to start this.
Okay, what we have here is shame versus rage. You feel guilty, you got demons that won't go away until Greg forgives you, until he lets you off the hook. And Greg, you're angry, you're frustrated. You want Ron's punishment to equal your loss, his life or your wife's. But here's the deal. Neither one of these things is ever gonna happen. So what we need to do is to learn how to control these emotions so that they stop controlling you.
He's never gonna let this go.
Why should I? You took my life away.
I made a mistake, okay?
Is that all it was to you?
I didn't want to kill you! Off!
Did you go through AA after the accident?
I didn't have a drink in that hell for 3.5 years. 3.5 years!
You didn't answer my question!
Jenny!
Oh, sweetheart. And please don't do that again, all right?
What happened to your face?
Nothing, sweetheart. It'll be fine. Now go upstairs, take a warm bath. Cecilia, then me.
Just because she can't admit it to you doesn't mean that she doesn't know what's going on. Lynn, your 10-year-old daughter ran away because she can't stand to be in her own house. This isn't about you or your husband's reputation. Look at what you're doing to your children. And how do you think you're going to feel if he ever hits Jenny?
He would never do that. What do you expect me to do? This is my life. I don't know anything else.
Your husband abuses you. Your family is in trauma, and you are the only one who can do anything about it.
There's no place I can go. No place.
I am tired of the park. What should we do now? I know. Let's go shopping.
I was still living with my parents when I married Jason. I wasn't even your age.
What about your parents? Do you think you could take the children and go stay with them for a while?
No, they're dead. Jason's the one with the big family.
Well, what about someone from his side?
No, they all think he walks on water.
Any friends? Anybody you can call?
Oh, well, our circle isn't very broad. They're mostly business people, and somehow they're all connected to him, and they would just blame me anyway.
Lynn, this is not your fault.
The first time he hit me, we were on our honeymoon, and I have stayed with him for 18 years. What does that say about me?
Listen, leaving is always the hardest thing to do.
I'm sorry, I can't do this.
You've already done it. You've admitted there's a problem.
Mrs. Maxfield, would you ever consider going to the police?
People have no idea who you are dealing with. My husband does not lose gracefully. If I did that, I would never see my children again.
Jess.
Hey.
Lynn Maxfield is going to need some legal advice, and she's not sure what kind of financial access she has.
Okay, we'll just send her out.
Oh, wait. That background check on Norma Fishman. Found a cousin.
You're kidding. That's great.
What is it with you and this woman?
I grew up without a family. I know what it's like to be alone at the beginning of your life. I can't imagine what it's like being alone at the end. I'm gonna get Lynn.
Oh, that's me. Tess Robinson. Yes, she is. What? When? What hospital? I'm on my way. Tell Lily I had to leave.
Jenny, come to take you home.
Daddy?
You can't do this.
Mom, what's going on?
We have a court order instructing us to place these children in the custody of their father.
Who'd you pay off this time?
Lynn, you're unstable.
This woman has just removed herself from an abusive domestic situation.
My wife is a violent alcoholic. She can't even think for herself, let alone our children.
I won't let you take the children.
Mom!
Oh, Jason, please don't do this
to
me.
You're lucky I didn't press kidnapping charges on you. Jenny, you come with me.
How the hell can you do this to her after everything she's been through?
Kathy, there's nothing we can do right now.
No, no, no. No, no.
Did you see her face? Do you see what he does to her?
Jenny, I love you.
Oh.
Mama?
Broke my damn hip.
What happened?
I was making spaghetti. One minute, Michael was at the table. The next, he was right behind me, grabbing at my spoon. Had to have my spoon. He burned his hand in the water. When I tried to help him, he pushed me away. He's so strong now. We were near the back stairs, and I fell right down.
I'm so sorry, Mama.
What are we gonna do with our boy, Tess? What are we gonna do?
Just a mild sedative, just enough to calm you down so you can get some sleep tonight.
I don't want to sleep.
You have to meet with a lawyer in the morning, and you need to be thinking clearly.
You want me sober.
If you want your kids back, you're going to have to work for it.
So I want you to lie down here for just about 10 minutes. Just relax. Let this stuff do its job, okay?
Hi. Maxfield's going to have his sharks all over us tomorrow, so Kathy better be ready.
Are you?
What do you mean?
I mean, this is a guy that doesn't play by the rules. How far are you willing to go to help Lynn Maxfield?
I'll drive her out of state myself, if it means getting her and those kids away from that son of a bitch.
Here, I thought you were going soft on me. Kathy.
Malcolm already chewed me out. Is there anything else you'd like to add?
Yeah. Take care of her. She trusted you enough to come here, so you must be doing something right. For a change.
Was it this hard for you in the beginning?
It's still this hard for me. She shouldn't be alone tonight.
All right, I'll take her to the shelter and I'll stay with her just as soon as I get the write-up done.
Yeah, take a cab. Don't forget the lights. Okay, Emily, let's go.
You got your Buckley? This was the best day of my life.
Great. We can really use you around here.
Oh, I'm not coming back.
You're not?
Well, I called my brother, and I told him I'm ready to try working at his fish market again. It smells, but he pays me.
Oh.
San Francisco Assistance Center? Oh, hold on 1 second. It's for you.
Hello? Is this Dr. Buckley? Well, no, I'm his psychiatrist, not his physician. What's wrong with him? DOA?
Mr. Fishman? Hi.
Who are you?
My name is Lily Gannon, and I'm here to talk to you about your cousin, Norma.
I don't have a cousin, Norma.
Wait. Maybe you didn't know each other, but she was your father's cousin's daughter. Mm-hmm. And she just recently passed away.
She leave me anything?
No, she died homeless. That's why I'm here. I need someone from the family to come down and claim the body so she can have a proper burial.
I don't even have a pension. I can't afford no funerals.
Look, I'll pay for the funeral. Okay?
You're not family.
She deserves somebody. Everybody does.
Lynn, are you ready to go?
Hey, it's almost 10, and I guess you're not showing, so I'll talk to you whenever. Yeah, whenever.
She's upstairs. I was afraid to
stop.
But Mr. Maxfield always says no police.
You have no...
Lynn.
She needs help. You said so yourself.
She needs help because you beat the hell out of her.
My wife knows what her problems are. God knows I've tried to point them out to her. But she's weak. She doesn't understand that you can't just have something handed to you. You've got to work for it.
Lynn, don't. Don't let him ruin the rest of your life.
What life?
He is wrong, not you. Not you.
No, she's not going to shoot me. Because she knows that I love her. Deep down, she knows that. Lynn, I want you back. I want us to be a family again. I'll try harder, I promise.
Lynn, if you go back, he's just going to do it again.
Never again, Lynn, never. I promise, really.
Unless you stand up to him, he's never going
to... Shut up!
You leave! Leave, Lynn!
God!
Leave! Leave!
Jason, I'm sorry.
Woman, you're not leaving me back!
Stop it! I said stop it!
Stop it, Daddy!
Leave her alone.
Jenny.
Oh, what's going on?
Thank you, man.
I just got a call from the cops. Ron Colby's dead. Hey, it wasn't me, I swear.
No, I know, I know. He wrapped his car around a telephone pole. He was drunk.
Was there anybody else?
No. No, just him.
Thank God.
Night, Norma.
Got a date.
I know.
Maybe this isn't the right thing. I mean, we're friends. Maybe we should just leave it at that.
I saw something tonight. And it was so ugly. I want to feel something good.
How long is that right? It's so wrong. Do we let it?